subscribe my channel for G and NEET.
Hello students, good morning all of you. Today in our video I want to explain the chapter name. It is work, energy and power. In yesterday I was discussed by someone asked me what is the main differences between the conservative and non-conservative forces. So that's why I need to explain in yesterday. But today, so I want to continue that chapter, that is work, energy and power. So in this we want to learn from the basics. So that is, what is the energy, which type of factors are depends on energy, what is the power, which type of factors are depends on the power, what is work, which type of factors are depends on work. And now we want to learn about the work. Okay, so the work, the term, it is very common word in our daily life. We are listening very oftenly, we are listening it. But how many you know about the proper definitions of these three terms? So now you have to discuss. So dear students, before going to that, you have to subscribe our channel and like, share, comment in our comment session. So let's start our topic. Work, energy and power. Work, energy and power. This video only contains discuss about the only about work, that is. So how we can define the work? So already yesterday I told that statements will not be by hearted. Just you have to understand the concept and you have to write the definition in your own words. Okay, then only it will be genuine concept understanding by you. Okay, right. So what is meant by a work? So work, it is nothing but it is one of the scalar product, which can work is a scalar product of force and displacement. So this is a simple definition. Okay, so here you need not to write if for some force will be acting on a body, if there is a displacement, then the work done be act. This can be said to the work done. So not at all this entire matter. So just you have to put the scalar product of force and displacement is known as the work or work done. So therefore it can be denoted by the letter W. It is equal to scalar product means F dot S. It can be expanded by W is equal to Fs cos theta. Right, so here you need to put the modulus of S, Fs cos theta. Okay, for suppose here there is a body having the mass M and the force will be acting in this direction and the displacement will be in this direction. The angle between these two, it is theta. Okay, so then the work done should be W is equal to Fs cos theta. So here you need to remember W is equal to F cos theta into S. F cos theta into S. The meaning of this one, it is nothing but the component of force is along with the displacement. The component of force direction is along with the displacement, then you can multiply it by the displacement. Okay, it means, so the force component will be along with the displacement, then the force component, if which is nothing but F cos theta, is multiplied by the displacement. Okay, similarly W, it is equal S cos theta into F. This is also work done. Here in the meaning, it is the displacement component is in the direction of the force, then the displacement component was multiplied by the force. Here the force component is in the direction of displacement, then the force component is multiplied by the displacement into S. Okay, so these are the simple and easiest trick you have to understand, right? And coming to the basic information about the units and dimension formula of work done. So that is units for the force it is Newton, and displacement it is meter. The work done, it is equal to Newton meter, or it can be said to be joule. Okay, right. And next, the dimension formula for work done, it is equal to the dimension formula for force. All are you remember? You have to remember force, it is equal to ML T minus 2. Keep in your mind always. And the displacement, it is equal to the dimension formula of displacement, it is length. Then it can be written as ML 2 T minus 2. Okay, so this is the dimension formula, this is the units. Okay, for the work done. Okay, next, if theta is equal to 0 degree, then the work done should be W is equal to Fs cos theta, it is equal to Fs cos 0, it is equal cos 0 is equal to 1, then W is equal to Fs. So there is a chance to maximum work done, right? There is a chance to maximum work done. So here, so this is a body on the floor having the mass m, and so this is the force F, and this is the displacement. The angle between, this is the force and this is the displacement, the angle between these two, theta is equal to 0, then the work done should be maximum. So in this situation, the work done should be maximum. If theta is equal to 90 degrees, then W is equal to Fs cos 90, it is equal to 0, right? The work done should be minimum. So first, suppose here there is an object having mass m, and here this is the force, okay, and there is no, this is, for suppose this is the displacement, here theta is equal to 90 degrees, right? So both are perpendicular to each other, then there is no work done, so the object will not be moves. Okay, right. So this is the one condition. And another, it is if theta is equal to 180 degrees. If theta is equal to 180 degrees, means so this is a force and this is the displacement, yes, okay, then the work done should be W is equal to Fs cos 180, it is equal to minus 1, cos 180 it is equal to minus 1, then minus Fs, the work done should be negative, the work done should be negative, okay, right. So for better understanding, you have to learn some examples of the numericals, then you can understand very easily. So let's coming to the one numerical. So this is the one numerical for the better understanding of work done. Let a block 10 kg force acting by 50 newtons, quotient of friction mu is equal 0.1. find the work done by external force F and frictional force on mass of 10 kg when displacement by 5 meters. Okay, so let us draw a diagram what they given to us. So this is the surface, and there is a mass having 10 kg, right? And it has applied by the force, it is nothing but how much, it is 50 newton, and it is displaced by how much distance, that is 5 meter. Okay, and the frictional force here, it is 0.1. okay, and now we have to find the work done by external force F and the frictional force on the mass 10 kg. So already you know the formula for the work done by external force, that is equal, W is equal to F into S. Okay, F it is nothing but 50 newtons, S it is nothing but displacement 5 meters, that is equal 250 joules. Okay, 250 joules because of this is a positive. Why? The work done, the force acting on the body and the displacement of the body is both are in same direction. Okay, this is the F and this is the S, then the work done should be positive, therefore 250 joules. So work done by the friction. Work done by the friction. Okay. So here we need to find the frictional force. So how you can what type of friction is there here? The body is at rest motion, rest position. Then here there is a limiting friction. F limit is equal mu into n. Mu into n. Okay. Mu into n. N means normal reaction. What is normal reaction here? So normal reaction it is also 10 g. Normal reaction it is 10 g. So let mu f it is equal to mu until it is 0.1 into 10 g. Okay, g for g is equal to 10 meter per second square, and it is equal 0.1 into 100. It is nothing but 10. Okay. F it is equal, limiting friction it is equal 10 newtons. Just you can write W it is equal F limit into limiting frictional force into displacement. It is 10 into displacement nothing but 5, it is equal 50, what is that, joules. In which direction? So this is the displacement and this is the frictional force, will be opposite and minus 50 joules, right? Now let us see another problem. So in above case, find work done by gravitational force and a normal reaction. In above case means a block of 10 kg force acting on 50 newtons and quotient of friction mu is equal 0.1, and find the work done by gravitational force and a normal reaction. So here, so this is the surface having a 10 kg of mass, block of 10 kg mass, and it consisting of 50 newtons of force and displacement by how much it is 5 meters, right? And here the frictional force, the frictional quotient of friction mu is equal 0.1, right? So here the weight of the body should be, it is W is equal to mg, it is 10 into g, should be acting in downwards. Okay. And this is the displacement, the direction of the displacement, yes. Okay, this is the force. Okay, so here these two are acting as 90 degrees. Okay, due to the gravitational force I want to speak here, gravitational force. So here this is the external force, but here this is the gravitational force. The direction of gravitational force and to the displacement of the body should be in perpendicular to each other. Fg is perpendicular to the S. Then W it is equal to Fg into S in S cos theta, where cos theta it is nothing but 90 degrees. Then it is equal W is equal to 0. The work done should be 0. Okay. And coming to the normal reaction. So here there is the normal reaction acting 10 g, right? So this is the force acting on the body. These are also, this is the normal reaction force and this is the displacement. This is the normal reaction force n and this is the displacement s. There can consisting of 90 degrees, right? Here also by the normal reaction the work done should be also 0. By the gravitational force, the work done is equal to 0. Okay? Right. So, understand here. If a man, there is a man, have lifting an object mass of 50 kg and walking on the platform in this direction. Here in this case, the work done due to the gravitational force, is equal to 0, right? Because of the gravitational force should be acting in the downwards and the displacement should be in this direction, right? Both containing of 90 degrees and the work done should be is equal to the 0. So, in this meaning, the man cannot have done the work in the direction of according to the gravitational force. Okay, So work done by gravity, it is zero. But work done by frictional force is not equal to the zero. Right? So by the frictional force, he can moves with some displacement. The frictional force will be in the opposite direction. Displacement will be now another direction. Right? The work done by the frictional force is not equal to zero. But the work done by the gravity is equal to zero. The work done by the gravity is equal to zero. Understand? Right. So let's see another case. So let us say a block of mass having in the inclined plane. So it means this is the inclined. There is a mass m here, right? So the displacement of the block is in this direction, and after some time it will, the mass should be here. This is m, okay? And the length of the inclined plane, that is L. Here this is the angle theta, and this is 90 degrees, okay? So here what we can define, so this is the displacement in this direction. Fine. Work done due to gravity or gravitational force and normal reaction. So let us try. Okay, let's see. Here, work done by the normal reaction. So here, for example, this mass consisting of some weight m or whatever it is. So the normal reaction will be acting in upward direction, that is n. It is equal to mg. Okay. And the displacement should be in this direction, that is equal they consisting of, this is the displacement and this is the normal reaction. Here there is 90 degrees, right? So this is normal reaction, this is displacement. Then f s cos theta, it is equal to n s cos 90, right? It is equal to 0. Cos 90 is equal to 0. Then w n, it is equal to 0. The work done by the normal reaction is equal to 0. Now work done by the gravity. So the weight of the body due to the gravity should be acting in this direction, mg. Okay. And it is this is in up downward direction, and this can be the displacement. Here the gravitational force should be in downwards, that is a physical mg. And here this is the displacement. There is a how much angle here it is. So this is theta, this is 90, here it is 90 minus theta. Okay. And let's write, you have to, where the mg will be along with the inclined in downward direction, that is mg sin theta into, what is that? S. S means displacement, how much displacement it is, length L. Mg into mg sin theta into L, that is nothing but mgl sin theta. This is the work done by the gravitation, work done by the gravity. Okay, are you understand? Or you can write from the equation directly, W is equal to Fs cos theta, where Fs, S means L cos theta. Theta means 90 minus theta. Here cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta. And then F means Mg, the gravitational force which was acting downwards. MgL, it is nothing but sin theta. MgL sin theta. Okay. So the work done by the gravitation mgl sin theta, the work done by the normal reaction, it is equal to 0. So in this inclined plane, so in this horizontal, so in this, these are the various cases we have to find the work done. Okay. Now let us discuss the work done in case of a spherical shell, or shell, it is the hemisphere. It means having the radius at all the points is same. Okay. So this is the spherical shell having the radius r, right? And here there is a mass m, this is the force f, and this can be moving from here. So this is the mass m. Here this is the radius r, where the theta, it is angle, it is theta. Okay, now let us find the work done by the force, the work done by the force F. Here this is the displacement S, we have to see. Okay, and we have to observe. So this is the displacement from the center point to edges. Okay, so this is also the displacement, so which is in the direction of, which is in the direction of force. Okay, so here you need to understand. So at which we have to, in earlier we have to say that, that is W, it is equal to Fs cos theta, where W is equal to F cos theta into S, where W, it is equal to S cos theta into F, S cos theta into F. Okay, by this concept we have to doing this numericals. Okay, here this is the surface and there is a block mass m, and this is the force and this is the displacement. The force displacement, force component should be along with the displacement, then it can be multiplied by the displacement, F cos theta into S. This is the W. Okay, the component of force, it is equal to F cos theta. Here F cos theta. Okay, what is meant by F cos theta into S? It is meant by the component of force is along with the displacement. Okay, and next, the displacement, the component of the displacement in the direction of force, then it multiplied by the force. Therefore, S cos theta into F, it is equal to W. Okay, so here the displacement of the mass of the object is along with the direction of the force. The displacement of the, the displacement of the object is in the, along with the direction of the force. Then the displacement should be here. What is the displacement here? So this is the r and this is the theta. This is r cos theta adjacent, it is opposite r sin theta. Let it be, we can write that, whereas r sin theta into F, it is equal W. Okay, here the display, the work done by the force F, it is equal r sin theta into F. This is the, this is the work done by the force here. Okay, how can you find that? So here, if the displacement of the object should be in the direction of force, then the displacement component should be multiplied by the force. The displacement component r sin theta multiplied by the force. The displacement component is multiplied by the force. Okay, so this is the concept. Right, concept you have to practice and note it. And one more example we have to practice, that is here. Here there is an object by the pulley, right? And this is the 1 kg of mass block, and another, it is 2 kg of block. Okay, right? So this is the tensional force T, and this is the tensional force T. It can be displaced by, it can be displaced by 3 meters in downwards. Automatically this can be displacement by 3 meters in upwards. Okay, this is downwards and this is upwards. And now in this case, so we need to find work done. Okay, find work done by the gravitational force, gravitational force on each mass, on each mass, and find tension force, find tension force on each mass, on each mass, when 2 kg mass is moves down 3 meter displacement. Okay, so this is the our problem. So now we have to find the work done by the gravitational force on each mass. Work done by the gravitational force on 1 kg of mass. Work done by the gravitational force on 2 kg mass. Right, let us write how we can find the work done by the gravitational force on 1 kg mass. It is equal, it is 1 kg. So here the weight should be 1 g, the weight should be 2 g. Here the force should be acting downwards 1 g, and displacement it is upwards. So this is the force and this is the displacement. Both are in opposite direction. Let us, the work done should be minus Fs. It can be 1 g into, what is s? Displacement, how much it is? It is 3 meter. G, it is nothing but, let it be 10 meter per second square. Then 1 into g, 10 into 3, it is equal minus 30 joules. Minus 30 joules because of the force acting in downwards and the displacement should be in upwards. Both are in opposite, then we can, the work done should be negative. In case of 2 kg, the work done due to the gravitational force on 2 kg mass, it is equal, the force acting in downwards and the displacement should be in downwards, both are in same direction, it can be Fs. It is positive. F means 2g into 3, it is equal 20 into 3, 60. 60 joules. Okay, so this is the positive. So the work done by the gravitational force on each mass should be by the 1 kg of mass, that is minus 30 joules, and the 2 kg of mass, that is 6. Now let us find the work done and the tensional force on each mass. Work done by the tensional force on each mass. So here the acceleration due to gravity should be in downwards, that is A, and here the body is moving in upward direction, the acceleration due to gravity is in upwards. Let us find the tensional force at first. So how we can find tension? By the free body diagram. So you can find that, that is how can you find, whereas in case of 2 kg of mass, so this is the 2 kg and here this is the 2 g and this is the t. Okay, this is 2 kg and then you can write that, what is that, whereas 2 g minus t, it is equal 2 a, mg minus t is equal to ma. Okay, and in case of free body diagram of 1 kg block, 1 g minus t, here t is in upwards, g is in downwards, acceleration is upward direction, that's why t minus g is equal a. From both of they can be solving. So here this can be 2 g minus g, that is equal, you can write g is equal, what is that, 3 a. A is equal to g by 3. Now let us find t value. How can you find t value? T minus g is equal to a. What is a? A is equal to g by 3. T minus g is equal to g by 3. So 3t minus 3g is equal to g. So 3t is equal to 4g. Right? T is equal to 4 by 3g. So this is the tensional force. Okay, if you feel this is a lengthy process, just for a short tick, for find the tensional force, in this case it is, what is that, 2m1 m2 by m1 plus m2 into g. What is m1? 1 kg. What is m2? 2 kg. So here 2 into 1 into 2 by 1 plus 2 into g. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 4, 1 plus 2, 3 into g. So t is equal to 4 by 3 g. Okay, so now work done by the tensional force on 1 kg body. 1 kg mass. Okay, that is equal to Fs. You can write that is equal to Fs. F nothing but tensional force. Here it is 4 by 3 into G means 10 into S means what is that? 3 meters. 3 will be cancelled out. It can be what is that? 40 joules. Okay, and coming to the work done by the tensional force on 2 kg of mass, it can be, it is equal to minus Fs, it is equal to 4 by 3 into G into 3. Okay, 3 will be cancelled out, minus 40 joules. So why we can take the minus value, negative it is here, the displacement, okay, the displacement and the tension will be opposite directions. Here the displacement and the tension here both are in same direction. So both are in same direction, we put as it is positive, and both are in opposite direction, we can take the negative. So the net tension force it is equal to what is that? Minus 40 plus 40, it is equal to 0, right? The net tension force on the system, it is equal to always 0. So the net work done by the tensional force is equal to 0. The net work done by the tensional force is equal to the 0. So dear students, this is our topic today. So I hope all are you very understanding, and you feel good. So dear students, please subscribe our channel and like, share, comment if you like the video. Thank you.